I've had a very informative visit here at QEII Hospital with Catherine King, seeing an emergency department that has gone increased 20,000 patients going through there in the last few years as it's become a more modern emergency department. But also we've met a lot of doctors and health professionals who say that this is a hospital under pressure, servicing all of Brisbane's south sides, but with increasing pressures.
Well, of course, what we've seen, unfortunately, from the federal government is cuts to our public hospital system. And here in the south of Brisbane, that's been around over $20 million worth of cuts to public hospitals, $3 million here at the QEII. When you've got a hospital that's under pressure with emergency department presentations and the acuity of patients coming through increasing, that $3 million is really significant. Across the board in the south of Brisbane, those cuts have meant less capacity to actually look after outpatients, some 70,000 outpatients visits, and less capacity in our emergency departments, over 40,000 outpatient visits in those sort of represented by those cuts that the Morrison government has done. This is a government that sees health only as something to be cut. It doesn't see it as an investment, and it makes a real difference here to the QEII that they've lost $3 million under the Abbott-Turnbull-Morrison government. We might have a new Prime Minister here in the country, but they are the same old cuts, the same government that is cutting our public hospital funding, making it harder and harder for these great hospitals that we have and the staff that we've met today to do their services. Labor wants to fix that. We've said we're going to reinvest $2.8 billion into our public hospitals, making sure that our staff here at the QEII can continue to deliver and do the jobs that they need to do to providing terrific healthcare here for the people in the south.
Thanks.